Three Buffalo girls going around the outside. Han har gjort betydligt mer än så. Malcolm McLaren, mannen som skapade Sex Pistols, den berömda klädnästan Let It Rock och mycket, mycket annat. Han sitter här i ZTV på väg soffa. Very welcome to ZTV på väg, Mr. Malcolm McLaren.
Hi.
How are you doing?
Yeah, not bad. Very hot. But I'm okay. I'm chilling out here because it's in the shade. So I'm happy for the moment.
Okay. Malcolm som kommer från ett regnigt London, han tycker det är väldigt varmt här i Sverige just nu. Och han har varit här för att tala för den svenska musikbranschen, makthavare och journalister om framtidens underhållningsindustri, alltså the future of entertainment. What did you talk about during your speech, Malcolm?
It's a karaoke world.
A karaoke world?
That's what I talked about.
Tell me more.
Well, for the last 5 years, I've been very dazed and confused as to trying to understand why every group that seems to come out of this huge rock and roll pot has to have about 5 adjectives to describe it. It's either speed garage meets post-grunge meets a little funk and maybe a sprinkling of punk, or it's a disco funk group with hard rock edge meets happy house meets or it's a group that has old English Kinks riffs meets modern and I kind of thought language now in music is getting to be a problem as everybody seems to be creating a new genre every day. Dance music was perhaps the beginnings of that, simply because after punk rock, dance music was the next, in my opinion, most underground, do-it-yourself form of music where the participation by the audience was virtually as important as the group. The Sex Pistols were about that. Dance music was about that. And in the 90s, I kept trying to think, well, why do people keep having to create these new genres when at the end of the day, it really is all about something called karaoke, which is to take everything that pop culture has developed over 40 years and for the first time be able to grab it in a world that doesn't have any enemy, if you like. We don't know any longer what to rebel against.
The music doesn't have any enemy, so there's not.
So it's a complete acceptance. Mm. How on earth do you make anything that is not pretend rebel rock? And I suddenly thought to myself, well, you don't. What you do is you take it all and you put it into a pot any way, which way you like. To be against the establishment is not to be in any particular category. Dance music has tried to do that, but it has also now found a zillion different categories. But when I was in the Far East and visited these strange places called karaoke bars, I suddenly thought, this is the future. You can sing anything you want. All genres can be put together in one group. Suddenly I thought, this is the future. This is multimedia. This is the ultimate democratic
karaoke
form of pop music.
We're going to talk about it more. McLaren säger att det har liksom blivit en massa olika konstellationer, en massa olika sorters musik. Men viktigast av allt är att musiken nu för tiden har ingenting att vara rebellisk mot. Alltså den här gamla grejen som kanske var grunden till både rocken en gång i tiden och till punken som Malcolm bör känna till. Det finns inte längre, det finns ingenting längre någonting att göra uppror mot. Istället så har han hittat framtiden i karaoken i Fjärranöstern. Vi ska prata mer om det här. Men här är lite bitar, en liten tillbakablick på Malcolm McLarens karriär.
Darling, Ja.
McLaren, ja. Ja, han har gjort det mesta inom nöjesindustrin. Hans karriär den börjar i mitten av 60-talet när han träffar designern Vivian Westwood. De inleder ett nästan 20 år långt samarbete. De visar kläder i London och Paris och öppnar också butiken Let It Rock på Kings Road i London. Parallellt med klädproduktionen växer också McLarens intresse för rockmusik. Och 1973 träffar han det legendariska rockbandet New York Dolls i New York. Sen var det ju dags för det här. Ja, Sex Pistols. Den 6 november 1975 stod så bandet på scenen på St. Martin's College of Art i London. Konserten, ja, den avbröts efter 10 minuter. Sex Pistols, de blev snabbt ett skandalomsusade rockband som McLaren längtat efter. Men historien om Sex Pistols, den blev kort och intensiv om man bortser ifrån förra årets återförening. 78 hade alla fått nog. Alla. I början av 1979 dör basisten Sid Vicious av en överdos heroin, bara 21 år gammal. Men trots att bandet valt att gå skilda vägar så fortsätter McLaren sitt Sex Pistols-företag och lever gott på intäkterna. 80 släpper han både plattan och filmen The Great Rock'n'Roll Swindle som handlar om just Sex Pistols. Men nu är ju inte Malcolm McLaren bara Mr. Sex Pistols. Naturligtvis så är han också artist. Han har experimenterat med en massa musikgenrer och gjort det nästan omöjliga. Och det var väl just en sån mix som resulterade i den första kommersiella rap- och scratch-hiphop-singeln någonsin. Buffalo Girls 1981. Signerad, ja, McLaren. Det blev en enorm succé och McLaren, han släpper 2 år senare debuten Duck Rock. Under 80-talet så bryter McLaren med Vivian Westwood. Han gör bizarra musikaler och arbetar med alla från Bootsy Collins till Madonna. 90-talet det följer samma spår. McLaren han fortsätter arbeta inom tv och producerar reklammusik och släpper 93 plattan Paris i Europa där bland andra skådespelerskan Catherine Deneuve sjunger.
Of all the things that you have done, Malcolm McLaren, what are you the most proud of?
Well, survival, to have another idea, the ability to never really grow old and stupid and conservative and never become a member of the golf club fraternity.
That sounds
I'm very
like
proud of that.
Yeah. Okay. Is there any particular...
Although my generation are not my friends anymore, sadly, they're all married with mortgages sitting on corporate boards. Here I am, and my friends grow younger every 10 years. I'm with a new generation. So I feel sometimes, I wonder, how long can I keep that up? And I guess that notion of not caring about being responsible has allowed me. I'm one of these terrible outlaw characters, you know. It's sort of, I was brought up to think that only criminals and artists defy rules. And I suppose what I mean by that is you have to be an outsider to do anything.
And that's
been my premise,
yeah.
And my lifestyle.
Det som Malcolm McLaren är allra gladast över det är att han hela tiden har undgått att gå med i golfklubben som alla hans jämnåriga kollegor, han fyller snart 50 för övrigt, eller om han redan har gjort det. Istället så har han försökt hålla sig ung hela tiden och hela tiden suga efter nya godbitar. Men vad är egentligen han mest missnöjd? What are you the most unhappy with during your career? What has been the biggest mistakes?
Mm. Never thinking I'm intelligent enough. Never thinking I'm very good at anything. I think that in the end, one is always uncertain that what you're doing is good. And my mistake has been thinking that, because if I'm doing something bad and failing, in a way, if I look at it now, I have to say that's just as good, if not better sometimes, than being successful. Because being successful means you arrive. Once you arrive, you stop. It's like once you're on a train with a destination, the train arrives, you have to get off. I've always been this person that's getting on that train and always hoping it never arrives. And sometimes, because of losing friends on that kind of train, I suffer because I have to make new friends. But I can't seemingly get off that train. I can't seemingly ever arrive.
That's no mistake, is it?
No, I have to look back and say, that's okay. But meanwhile, my friends disappear. Mm. So it sometimes puts you in a position of loneliness. Mm. And that at the end of the day, when you add it all up, friends are the most important thing. If you don't have friends, life isn't really interesting. And life is interesting when you have friends, you know.
Det är viktigt att ha vänner. Tänk på det. Malcolm har inte alltid lyckats att vara polare med de olika artister och i de olika projekt han har hållit på. Just nu, så, som han nämnde tidigare, så håller han på med ett Spice Girls-liknande projekt. Four Girls? Fem tjejer från Kina. Alla från någon sorts karaoke-kultur som ska bli en sorts kinesiskt Spice Girls eller Rice Girls, som Malcolm McLaren för då. And I would like to ask you, we have these over here as well, Sisters of Sweden, it's one of like Spice Girls projects coming up.
Are they?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Are your
the Chinese, no, the difference is, I suppose,
yeah,
these girls from China don't sing anything other than what has already been sung before. In other words, they just reclaim all the past. They just sing Led Zeppelin, Rolling Stones, The Beatles, rap like Grandmaster Flash, sing along to disco tracks. They basically claim all the pop culture. And by doing that, they put it all into one bag. And out of that, I think their future is that they make an attempt at pointing towards the new, because they are uncategorizable, other than that one word, karaoke, which for me means democratic. I guess that's the difference, that they are... They are an Asian invasion.
En asiatisk invasion, säger Malcolm McLaren om sitt nya film. Och det är en grupp som kan sjunga precis vilken musik som helst. En väldigt demokratisk grupp. Han översätter karaoke med demokrati. Och de kan sjunga Led Zeppelin, Beatles eller vad 17. Den här skivan kommer för övrigt ges ut på ett svenskt skivbolag. Och very good luck with the group. It's the first group you have managed for years.
Michael. Since Boy George.
Since Boy George, yes. Thank you for coming to
Saturday Pleasure. Okay.